going to go over this percent mixture problem. 5 pounds of candy that is 20% chocolate is combined with a candy that is 40% chocolate. How many pounds of the candy that is 40% chocolate should be used and combined to get a candy that is 25% chocolate? All right, so here's our picture. Let's pretend we have like 3 bags of candy here. Actually, 2 bags, and we're going to pour it all in a big bag. So in the first bag, 20% of it is chocolate. We could write that as a decimal. Down here, I'm going to write that as 0.20. You can write 0.2 or 0.20. And 40% would be 0.40 or 0.4, and 25% is 0.25. And we look and see if we know how many pounds are in any of this. It says I have 5 pounds of the 20% chocolate. So I know this is 5 pounds. And then it wants to know how many pounds of the candy that is 40% should be used. So we don't know how much of the 40%. But if I'm putting in 5 pounds and I'm mixing it with X pounds, then I've got 5 plus X, or X plus 5 pounds in our mixture. Now what we're interested in is how much pure chocolate is in each of these bags. All right, so the pure chocolate in this first bag would be 20% of 5. So that's 0.2 times 5, 1/5 of 5, 0.20 times 5. There's all sorts of ways you can write that. And let's see, we're going to mix it with this other vat, and I want to know how much pure chocolate's in there. So that's 40% of X, because if there's X pounds, when you have 40% of it, it's 0.40 times X. So we could do 0.40 times X. And then the resulting mixture we want of this X plus 5 pounds, we want it to be 25% chocolate. So it's 25% of what's in there. And you need to use parentheses. What's in there is X plus 5 pounds of chocolate. And since you're putting in this much chocolate from the first bag and this much chocolate from the second bag, then there should be the same amount of chocolate in the resulting bag. So these should be equal. And that's your equation. Now, you can do this problem with decimals as is. Go ahead and multiply it out. Use your calculator. Be very careful. So let's do that way first this time. So I have 0.2 times 5, or 1/5 of 5. That's going to be 1. And I'm just going to write this as 0.4x. And I'm going to write this as 0.25x plus, and then you have 0.25 times 5 is going to be 1.25. So this is if I just want to, you know, deal with the decimals as is. And now I have variables on both sides of the equation. I'm going to subtract 0.25x over here. Well, it's easier to leave this as 0.40, so it's easy to line up my decimal points when I subtract. So I'm going to change that and write that as 0.40, so that when I subtract 0.25x from both sides, I'm going to get 0.15x on this side. And this means I need to subtract 1 from both sides as well. So let's do that. Subtract 1, and you have to line up its decimal, so I might write that as minus 1.00. So on this side of the equation, I'm going to get 0.25. And then to solve for x, you have to divide by 0.15. All right, now, you can't leave an answer mixed with decimals and fractions. So we need to simplify this. So the first, you can get out your calculator, but what's going to happen, it's not going to come out evenly in decimal form. So instead we need to make this a reduced fraction. So the first thing I'm going to do is multiply the top and bottom by 100, right, so that I could just write 25/15. Multiplying by 100 means I can move the decimal place 2 to the right in both the numerator and denominator, and then we just reduce that. So 5 goes into both of those numbers, so that's 5/3 or 1 2/3. So what this means is 1 2/3 pounds, right? Because X stands for how much chocolate is in this first vat. Okay, so we found x. I'm going to now do this without decimals to show you the other way of solving this exact same equation without by clearing through the decimals, and then we'll go ahead and check the answer. So another way to solve this is by first clearing through by multiplying both sides by 100, and if you do that, you won't have any decimals to work with. So if I multiply both sides of the equation by 100, that means every single term, I have 100 times 0.20 times 5, that's just going to be 20 then, times 5. When I multiply it by that term, when I multiply it by this next term, I'm going to have 100 times the 0.40, that's going to give me 40, so I get rid of that decimal, and then when I multiply it by the one on the right side of the equation, that's going to make the number out in front 25. You don't also change the inside. It's only one of the numbers because this is not a separate term. So this is a way of getting rid of the decimals first before you solve the equation. From then on, it's going to look very similar to how I did it before. You're going to subtract 25x from both sides to get the variables on the left-hand side. And at the same time, we can go ahead and subtract 100 from both sides to get 15x equals 25 and reduce it to 5/3, or write 1 2/3. So in both cases, we got x as 1 2/3. Now we want to go back to the original problem and check. So here was the original problem. We got x equals 1 2/3 or 5/3, and remember where we put x, it was how much of the 40%. So I'm going to go ahead and just write 5/3 in here. And so if we add 5 plus 5/3, or 5 plus 1 2/3, that's going to be 6 2/3, or 20/3. It's up to you how you want to think about that. But you're adding 5 plus 1 2/3 is 6 2/3. If you change this to a common denominator, you would have 15/3 plus 5/3. So it's the same thing. All right, let's check how much of the pure chocolate we actually have in each vat here. So we have 0.2 times 5, which is the same thing as 1. Now we have 0.4 times 5/3. Now 0.4, notice I'm working with fractions and decimals. That makes it kind of confusing. 0.4 means 4/10, which is the same thing as 2/5. That's 4/10, multiplying by 5/3. So notice how the fives cancel? How convenient. So our answer is we've got 2/3 pounds of pure chocolate in this container. And then what do we have over here? We've got 25%. Remember, 25%, if you write that as a fraction, would be 25/100, or 1/4. So that's 1/4 of the total in there, which is 20/3. And oh, nice again, the 4 cancels into the 5, I mean into the 20, and that becomes 5/3. Right? So then the question is when this has, remember, what this is talking about is how much pure chocolate is in each of these containers. So I've got 1 pound of pure chocolate from this container, 2/3 pounds of pure chocolate from the second container. Is that the same as 5/3? Well, 5/3 is 1 2/3, isn't it? So yes, it does equal. So the answer to the problem is we want to know how much chocolate of the 40%. So use 1 2/3 pounds of the candy that is 40% chocolate. And we are done.